If you're familiar with the fundamentals of camera technique, then you know how much of an effect white balance can have on your images. Also, you probably have a basic understanding of how your camera's meter works, or at least how to react to its output to change your settings appropriately. Just beyond these basics, there are a few simple techniques that will allow you to fine-tune your white balance and get more accurate meter readings from your subject. To take advantage of these techniques, you'd only need to add a single cheap piece of equipment to your camera bag. That is, a gray card. These humble accessories start at less than $10, yet the amount of control they give you over the final image can be invaluable in tricky situations. For example, they allow you to obtain a good white balance reading from mixed light sources or get an accurate exposure reading from your camera's meter in a high contrast scene. Hang on to the end of this video because I'm going to explain everything you need to know about 18% gray cards and how you can use them to improve your shooting. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a full-time working photographer, video producer, video editor, and technology pro. If you like what you see in this video, stick around to the end because I've got a couple of photography, video, filmmaking, and editing freebies, and even some training courses I'll tell you about that will definitely help to improve your photo, video, and filmmaking work and help grow your business through earned media exposure. Earned media is basically free advertising. You can help support my channel by purchasing my training courses, requesting my free downloads, and hiring me to shoot or edit for you. Remember, I welcome your comments, questions, and more on all of my videos. If you like what you see, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified every time I upload a new video every single Wednesday. Just so you know, I've also done many other videos on improving your photography, video production, and filmmaking work, and I'll link to those in the description below. So, what is a gray card? A gray card is exactly what the name says it is. It's a card that is gray. More specifically, it is what's known as middle gray, or 18% gray. The number is important because 18% gray is what your camera's meter is trying to calculate when it meters to expose for a scene or the photograph that you're shooting. This means if you put a gray card in front of your subject and take a meter reading off of it, you will get a correct exposure regardless of any tonal contrast that happens to be in the scene that you're shooting. Additionally, when used in conjunction with a camera's custom white balance feature, you can manually set a perfect white balance for everything that you shoot. This becomes especially important when you need to faithfully recreate colors in your images or scenes. The 18% gray card's main purpose is to allow users to make adjustments to their camera that affect, or rather allow, users to set up correct exposure at the beginning of a shoot. We use 18% gray because of the amount of light that is reflected off this card and how the camera's sensor interprets this data. It allows users to manually set up exposure that can be used in the raw workflow with DSLR, mirrorless, or video cameras. Light meters work the same way using the 18% gray as well. In other words, the 18% gray should only be used to check lighting ratios and lighting distribution to set your exposure. You can actually white balance your camera with it, but that's not recommended. I'll explain how to do that later in this video. To use the card, place the 18% gray card by the subject you are shooting, then set up the exposure using the camera's manual controls. This card is strictly used before the shoot to adjust for the specific lighting condition, and users really don't even need to shoot the image of the card. Just make the camera adjustments and you're good to go. That's all there is to it, really. The card's main focus is lighting and setting up proper exposure. The short answer to why we use 18% gray is simply this. If the light in an average scene being photographed or videotaped or filmed is averaged out, it will produce an 18% gray tone, which is known as neutral gray. So, film cameras, DSLR, mirrorless cameras, and even video cameras are all formulated to produce proper exposure when exposed to an 18% gray tone or middle gray. A great example of this is when shooting a landscape image that has a very light sky, but the foreground is pretty dark. 18% will allow the camera to make the exposure correct so that in the raw workflow, we can still see the sky and the foreground properly exposed. So let's put this use of a gray card into practice in a shoot in two easy steps. Step one, you want to start spot metering. To get started, the first thing you'll want to do is set your camera to the spot metering mode. While this is not absolutely necessary, the fact that the camera will only be metering from a small section in the center of the frame will help a lot, especially in circumstances where you cannot fill the entire frame with the gray card. It will also save you a lot of time when you use manual mode. And step number two is the actual metering. With the metering mode changed, all that you have to do now to take advantage of this technique is to put the gray card in your scene, point the center of the frame at it, dial in the exposure your meter gives you, and then just take the gray card away. Providing that the light doesn't change, you will now have an accurate exposure for any subsequent shot you take in this setup. Here's a couple of pro tips to make certain that shooting goes smoothly and that will make the process easier and more accurate for you. First, you should make sure that your subject remains in a similar position relative to the light source from where you took the gray card reading. For example, if you're taking headshots outside and the sun is lighting your subject from the front, that is one exposure reading. If you turn your subject to the side or completely around, that will affect your exposure and you will need to take another reading because the lighting on your subject's face has changed when their position has changed. In other words, they're not being lit from the front anymore, they're being lit from the side or the back, so you need a new reading because the exposure has changed. The second tip is when you're taking the exposure reading. Fill the frame with the gray card as much as possible if you can. This will help to ensure that your meter is only trying to expose for the card and not for anything else around the edges. That is, of course, if you don't do spot metering like I mentioned before. So what if we want to use this gray card to set your white balance? Although the basic white balance settings in cameras can be pretty good, they do tend to struggle at times. For example, tungsten bulbs can vary greatly in color temperature depending upon their quality and power output. This may lead to the basic tungsten setting on your camera failing to give you an accurate representation of the colors in whatever it is you're shooting. If you would like to learn more about how different types of bulbs affect the photos or scenes that you shoot, check out this video I did on the different types of bulbs used in filmmaking and photography. I'll link to that in the description below for you. There are two ways to use a gray card to set your white balance. The first is to use it to set your camera's custom white balance. The second method will allow you to use Lightroom or Photoshop or some similar program to set a white balance for your images after they have been taken. You can also use Adobe Camera Raw inside Photoshop if you don't have Lightroom and you're not too familiar with Photoshop itself. As mentioned, while you can use an 18% gray card to do a white balance, it's not something that I suggest as the results are balancing to the gray and not to actual white in your scene, but it does work. White balancing can be done both in camera and post-shoot in third-party editing software such as Photoshop and Lightroom like I mentioned, or Aperture or Capture One for photos, or for video in Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro or some other editing program. White balancing in camera gives you a better view on the LCD of how the images and footage have been shot rather than risking a blue or yellow cast in the raw data you are viewing in the camera. If you don't check while you're shooting, you may find these odd color casts in the images and footage that you shoot, and that will give you a lot more post-processing work later on. This can be applied to either raw workflows or a JPEG workflow in your software post-shoot using the white balance eyedropper tool in these editing programs for photos. White balancing in camera will allow you to spend less time editing when you are post-processing your images, so you should really do it at the time of the shoot. Shooting raw allows much more room to work with your images post-processing than what a user will have if they shoot in JPEG. The difference can be very amazing when you white balance, and the time you save will allow more time to shoot, which is your main goal. In the case you don't know the difference between RAW shooting and JPEG shooting, I've actually done a video on that topic, and I'll link to it in the description below. Additionally, white balancing your video footage properly will mean less rendering of the video footage when you go to edit it later in something like Adobe Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro. This is making sense to you, but I've got it in the comments section below. My question of the day is, how do you get proper exposure for whatever it is you shoot? Leave a comment below and let us know. If you found the info in this video useful, I'd like to hear about it from you. If you liked it and want to see more videos like this, then follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films. If you think what you saw was great, please like it. If you have an opinion, feel free to comment below. If you know someone who could benefit from the information I provided, please share the video. You can connect with me and my company, Jim Costa Films, on social media and online, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, LinkedIn, and the web by searching for Jim Costa Films. In fact, I currently have over 4,470 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. Thank you for sticking around this long. I mentioned at the beginning about some freebies and training. As a professional video producer and photographer, I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings to shoot with your DSLR, mirrorless, or video camera that will show you the settings that will allow your photos and particularly your videos to shine and stand out from the competition. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. Best of all, my cheat sheet specializes in shooting video with any type of camera. In it, you'll find all the info you need on important video techniques such as white balance, color temperature, frame rates, and more. I've also created an editing training for Adobe Premiere Pro. My Quick Start training is designed to get you up and editing video in under 2 hours and includes over 100 tips, tricks, and keyboard shortcuts for video editors to make their workflow go much smoother. And now, I'm also affiliated with Christina Nicholson, a fellow media veteran like myself who helps businesses and entrepreneurs reach tons of their ideal customers or clients through the power of media without spending big bucks on advertising. I've worked with Christina and used her advice and training successfully to grow my own business, so I know from firsthand experience that it works great. The program Christina and I are now offering is called the Media Mentoring Program, and it will help you to take advantage of mainstream media so you can stand out from the competition because it's not something that everyone has access to. Best of all, unlike paid ads and sponsorships, you can gain lots of exposure and credibility to become the go-to brand everyone talks about and wants to do business with without spending a fortune on advertising, because the training teaches you how to get exposure for your business or your products and services essentially for free. I'll link to those cheat sheets and training courses in the description below as well. There's videos on both courses that will give you an overview of how they can help you and links to get more information. Finally, if you follow me for a while now, you may know that I have a private community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers just like you on Facebook where I share other pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. It's a private group just for people in those industries and not a public group like my Jim Costa Films Facebook page. Anyone can see that. I love new members who want to share their work, learn from others, and also help others based on their own skills and experiences. You'll find a link to that group in the description below, so feel free to join it where you can learn even more.